stout of heart, but be ye warned, a wretched tale I tell. A tale of darkest deviance, a tale of holy hell. And though there's tales aplenty in fair Cornwall's oldest lore, doubt ye not, the like of this hath ne'er been heard before.
Listening in shadows bleak and long, and soon it
silver flasked dando snatching hand, and stood he back with smirking lips to wait his next demand. The monk could scarce believe his tongue, the taste was so divine. 'Twas golden honeyed tonic, 'twas the sweetest nectar wine, and uttered he in ecstasy, "My friends, I truly think, in all the worlds of men there cannot be a finer drink." And as in proof the drunken scoundrel drained the silver flask, "But if this drink be not of men," said he, "then I must ask, who brews such liquors smooth and pure that sets my soul aglow? Is this the drink of gods?" he asked, "for surely I must know." The stranger laughed a rasping laugh and shook his hooded head. "'Tis not the gods who drink this brew, but devils do," he said. "Then would that I a devil were," called Dando to the knight. "I'd drink to damned eternity my hellish heart's delight." "Your wish is my command, my friend," the hooded hunter hissed. But how his face contorted in the rising twisted mist. He bowed his head towards the monk, a sparkle in his eyes. Then up he leapt to Dando's horse, a claiming of his prize. And off they sped cross hill and field with all unnatural haste. The poor bewildered hunters roused their howling hounds and chased. But when they reached the Tiddy's banks, they watched not drawing breath, as Dando plunged headlong into the watery depths of devil.